Hi everyone, my name is Aysel. I am the in-house illustrator at Vectornator, and today I thought it would be fun to design a few custom avatars. I wanted to create some diversity, but also something that I like to call the feature bank, where I store all the features that make my avatars unique and combine them to create brand new characters. Get the template file from the description and let's get started. To start off, I create a very loose sketch. Avatars need to be simple, yet powerful. So try to work with as few details as possible, while also conveying the personality of your avatar. So here I've started with the ellipse tool, and I outlined the most basic shapes that form my character. For any irregular shapes, I chose to work with pen tool. Simply trace the sketch by tapping and dragging in the direction of the pad. But there is an easier way to do this. Even if I need a round edge, I tap the canvas once. And then I go back with the node tool and double tap on the nodes I just created. It's my quick tip for you. The nice thing about avatars is that they rely on symmetry. Duplicate and flip anything you create on one side to create the other. I know what you must be thinking, but no, this avatar is not based on me. But I would really encourage you to start with your own portrait. It's not only a great exercise, but also a great way to showcase your most identifiable features. Like, do you have piercings? Do you wear headphones all the time? Or a funky head? Go for that. After I reveal my colors, I usually tweak the gradients a bit. And I added some very subtle shadows on the right side of her face. I personally use multiply blend mode with a blue shade at low opacity. I gave dimension to her lips using the same shadow technique. I decided to give her more personality with a piercing, and that's it. Now I'm adding all her accessories and features in this rectangle here on the right. I'm calling this one my feature bank. Cool, moving on to our second avatar. It's going to get easier and easier from now on. I duplicate the one I just created and remove any details to make room for something new. So I've changed the shape of the eyebrows and the color of the eyes and the lips. As for the blush, I have another cool trick. Blur it out. Lower the opacity and duplicate it on the other side. For the hair, I decide to go for the short blonde curls. And I had a little bit of fun by adding a hat with the shape tool. Okay, I'm making two more, so let's duplicate the last avatar I did two times. The best part about this is that you can change features with a few simple taps, like skin color, hair type, eye shape. So you can create the avatar of any person you want. For my third character, I went with the darker skin, a fun lip color, and super fun green hair, which I'm creating with the brush tool. I tested out a few of my custom brushes, but in the end, I went with the first preset in our app. Then I created this funny shape that I definitely need to tweak with the node tool. I place it in the back, and with two small circles on top, we created space bonds. To add even more character, I added a septum ring. And I decided to adjust the bonds a bit so they look more realistic. But avatars can be as abstract or as close to the real deal as you want. It's really your choice. Last one. Just like before, I changed the eyebrows, the eyes, the nose, and the lips. Decided to go for short hair. And to give them a beanie, with a little extra detail here. I also thought some facial hair and some piercings would go super well. I only used the pen tool and shape tool for this, as per usual. And after all my characters are done, I'm adding all the little details and accessories on the right. You can also find them inside the Vectornator file below. Download it and create your own variations. And please tag us on socials so we can see them. Till next time.